Hello and welcome back. Today we'll get into section 4.6 on polynomial and rational inequalities. So we'll start with an example of a polynomial inequality. Let's take a look at f of x is worth x minus 5 quantity cubed by x plus 2 quantity squared by x minus 1. And we're going to find places where f of x is greater than 0. So first we'll use our let line. Let the x minus 5 cubed by x plus 2 quantity squared by x minus 1, let it temporarily equal 0. This is already in factored form, so we just set one factor at a time to 0 and solve, since we have a product equaling 0. So x could be 5, or x plus 2 could be 0, x could be negative 2, or x minus 1 could be 0, x could be equal to 1. So these are all the places where if we drew the two-dimensional graph, we would either cross or touch the x-axis. However, if we're just looking at is this above or below 0, we really just need the number line, and this is similar to when we had our quadratic inequalities. So we just line up our points in order, and one test point per section. Make sure you're showing your work on those test points. So we'll test out maybe a negative 6, a 0, a 2, and 25. Now the nice thing is, if we're in a product and quotient format, all multiplying and dividing on one side with zero on the other, we don't actually need the numbers, just the signs. So the negative 6, we have negative 6 minus 5, that is a negative. And we are cubing it. Negative 6 plus 2 is a negative, and we're squaring that negative. Negative 6 minus 1 is a negative. And we want to know, is this then greater than 0? I have 3, 4, 5, 6 negatives. Even number of negatives multiplied together is positive. Positive is always greater than 0, so we get to keep this. Testing out the 0, same idea. We still are working with an inequality that involves multiplication on one side, 0 on the other. Just take a look at your sign work then. So 0 minus 5 is negative. We have a negative cubed. 0 plus 2 is positive. We've got a positive squared. And 0 minus 1 is negative. And we want to know, is this greater than 0? So I have 3, 4 negatives is a positive. Positive greater than 0, we do get to keep that. We have to skip the number in the middle though. We said f of x had to be strictly greater than 0. If we plug in a negative 2, f of x exactly equals 0. So we have a little hole in there. Next, we'll try out the 2. So 2 minus 5 is negative. So we have a negative cubed. 2 and 2 is positive. Positive squared. 2 minus 1 is also a positive. And we want to know, is this greater than 0? This time I've got an odd number of negatives in my product, so my answer is negative. Negative greater than 0 is false. We don't want that section of the graph. So finally the 25. 25 minus 5 is positive. And we're cubing it. 25 and 2, positive. Happens to be 27, but you just care about the sign. 25 minus 1, also positive. And we want to know if this is bigger than 0. Well, sure enough, positive greater than 0 is true. We want this section of the graph as well. As far as endpoints, we have strict inequality, so we'll get a parenthesis here. This circle would also, you could consider it to be back-to-back parentheses. So our solution set, negative infinity up to, but not including negative 2, union negative 2 up through positive 1, exclusive on the 1. Union that up with the next interval from 5 to infinity. So we have three distinct sections. If we had an or equals here, we could cut it down to two distinct sections and just say from negative infinity to 1 and bracket on the 1. But since we are not allowed to actually equal 0, we had to have that jump there. So one way we can change from negative to positive and vice versa with these inequalities is touching the axis. We do have another way when we involve rational inequalities, though, and that is there can possibly be a jump. So we can have holes and jumps in rational inequalities. So remember when we took a look at rational functions where we had a hole, that hole might actually sit on an axis. So it's possible to have negatives over here, positives over here, without actually equaling 0 in the middle. Also, one of our basic functions, the reciprocal function, I'll just draw the rough sketch, not a scaled version of it, jumps from negatives to positives without touching the axis. Where those occur, though, those are happening when we are dividing by a zero, either in a way that got reduced out later or a way that didn't get reduced out. So let's take a look and we'll try out x squared plus x minus 42 all over x squared minus 5x plus 6 is less than or equal to 0. So my first let line is to pretend we had an equation. Then I'll clear the fraction. Zero times anything is zero, so the right hand side is still zero. Left hand side, we have our x squared plus x minus 42. So we'll go ahead and solve that. That one is actually factorable over the integers. So we have a positive 7 and a negative 6. So either x plus 7 is 0 or x minus 6 is 0. So x is negative 7 or x is a positive 6. So there's two important places in the number line, but not the only two important places. Remember, we do have to watch out for any of these possible holes or vertical asymptotes. So we also need a second let line. We let our denominator equal 0. So let x squared minus 5x plus 6 equal 0. This one also factorable over the integers. We're multiplying to a positive, adding to a negative, so we know it's minus minus. And we're multiplying to a positive 6, adding to a negative 5, 2, and a 3 will get those jobs done. So either x minus 2 is 0 or x minus 3 is 0. So x is 2 or x is 3. So we're actually going to make 4 cuts to our number line. So we have the negative 7, positive 2, positive 3, positive 6. when you're sketching your number line for something like this, where you're not making a nice two-axis graph, I'm not super concerned about the scaling. So four cuts mean five test points. So we'll try x is negative 10, x is 0, x is 2.5, x is 4, and x is 10. Something else that will help us out a little bit, I'm going to go with the factored version of this as far as my inequality. That way we can have all multiplying and dividing. We can use sign number arguments instead of having to plug all those in and get exact value fractions and things like that. So upstairs, factored into x plus 7 by x minus 6. Downstairs, factored into x minus 2 by x minus 3. And we want to know if we're less than or equal to 0 on each of these points. So the negative 10, we have two negatives upstairs. Denominator, also two negatives. And we want to know, is this less than or equal to 0? Four negatives in a multiplying dividing problem kicks us over to positive. Positive is not less than or equal to 0. So we throw away that piece of the graph. Drawing out the 0, positive, negative. Negative, negative. Possibly less than or equal to 0. Three negatives in a multiplying and dividing problem is negative. Negative less than or equal to 0 is true. So that means the point at the negative 7 is going to lean in. And let's see, yes, we do get to keep that negative 7. It's not making us divide by 0. The 2.5, positive, negative. 2.5 minus 6 is a negative number. 2.5 minus 2 is positive. 2.5 minus 3 is negative. Again, we want to know, are we less than or equal to 0? Two negatives kicks us positive. Positive less than or equal to 0 is false. We don't want stuff between 2 and 3. Now, you would think with this that we would put a bracket on here. Think about it for a second. I'll explain it at the end of the problem. See if you can figure out before the end of the problem why I'm not allowed to put a bracket on this 2. Alright, so we'll come back to that. I'll let you think about that while we're working. So 4 and 7 is a positive. 4 minus 6 is still in the negative territory. 4 minus 2 is positive, as is 4 minus 3. And we want to know, are we less than or equal to 0? 1 negative makes us a negative in a multiplying and dividing problem. So this one is true. So we keep all the stuff between the 3 and the 6. We'll talk endpoints again in a minute. 10, all 3 of these, or all 4 of these, rather, are positives. We want to know if we're less than or equal to 0. Positive less than or equal to 0 is false. We don't want that section. Okay, so one more hint on why the 2 is not going to get a bracket. The 6 will get a bracket, but the 3 also will not. So hopefully you noticed the reason why. Those are the numbers that would make us divide by 0. We're never allowed to divide by 0, even if we have this or equals. So this guy gets a parenthesis, this guy gets a parenthesis. And I didn't leave myself quite enough space to put my answer in the right spot, so we'll put it up here in our little corner here. So from negative 7 up to, but not including 2, union 3 exclusive to 6 inclusive. So those are the parts that we get to keep. Okay. So if you're looking for some problems to try out in section 4-6, I would try out 1 through 8 all. 9 to 65 on the odds. And if you're looking for challenge problems, 67 to 72 ask some interesting questions. And I'll try to create a similar kind of assignment on the My Math Lab for the folks that like that one. Okay, stay safe out there. Get in touch with me if you have any questions.